Ginger, today you need to watch this video if you're on it or want to be on it. I'm going to tell you briefly the benefits, but most importantly, when you should not take it, or if you're taking it, what you should be mindful of, because it can be dangerous. Now, a lot of people are on drugs for cholesterol, for blood pressure, for all these things. And a lot of times we can take natural supplements or natural foods, better yet, organic natural foods, to manage our bodies and our systems so we don't have to be on expensive drugs that often do more harm than good. That's what I'm talking about today. But I do want you to be aware of the negatives, because gingerol is the active ingredient in ginger, and it is medicinal in a way. So we have to respect it, and there can be downsides on other systems or interact with medications. It is quite powerful. So click like below. Let me know you like these types of videos. And in the comments, if you want my recipe for my ginger shots, in the comments, let me know. I'll make a video on it. It will be fun. Now, what does ginger do? The medicinal component gingerol has many effects on the body. Many. Anti-inflammatory. Inflammation leads to aging. We know that. And we're always trying to prevent chronic inflammation. And ginger has that effect. It's an antioxidant, clearing free radicals from pollutants from the metabolism of our body. A lot of people know it from when they're on boats or they're traveling or they're on vacation, because it's an anti-nauseant. So that property is often used. Now, weight loss, we have a problem with obesity in many countries, and a lot of people take ginger for weight loss, but if they're using it for weight loss, they also have problems like often diabetes and high blood pressure, and I'm going to talk about some of the worst times to take it for those today in this video. It can decrease blood sugars, which is a positive, but could be a negative for some. Helps with menstrual pain. It also has some anti-cancer benefits that many people tout and use it for, and this is being more and more studied. It has antimicrobial benefits, so it can fight some infections, and it's being studied for memory. So with all that good, what do you need to know if you're going to be taking it? Because it sure sounds good. I take it every other day. Let me tell you why you might not want to take it at certain times. So what are the things to watch for? And there's several. The first one is, it helps stimulate bile production. Now that's a good thing normally, because it helps in digestion, and many people use ginger for that. There's a couple problems. One is, if the stomach is empty, that can irritate it, because it increases acid production, and thus you're going to have heartburn, maybe some discomfort. Some people get gas with this. The second thing with the bile production is, if someone has gallstones, or these are stones in the gallbladder, and the gallbladder contracts to get rid of the bile to help digest the food, you can get an obstructive gallstone, or just pain because the stones are working around in there. And depending on the type, the amount, and your gallbladder illness, it can make that worse. So if you have gallbladder problems, you haven't had your gallbladder out, it's something to keep in mind. You're like, oh, that's irritating me more recently. It could be ginger. Now, it lowers two things. Number one is sugar. So it can lower the blood sugar. And for many people, that's a good thing, because people are running around with slightly high sugar and high blood pressure, or metabolic syndrome, which is a complex constellation of problems with obesity. The sugar's running rampant, the blood pressure running rampant, it affects your sleep, so on and so forth. But the two things it's lowering, if it's lowering the sugar and someone is running a low sugar anyway, or they're on medications to lower the sugar, like diabetes medications, the sugar can bottom out. So hypoglycemia is not good. It causes a lot of problems, obviously, from a jittery feeling to even passing out. And when the sugar bottoms out, if people don't get their sugar up, it can be a big issue. So be mindful in that case. And the second one is lowering blood pressure. Most of you are going to say, that's a great thing. My blood pressure is running a little high. Many people have that problem. The problem comes if someone's running a low blood pressure to begin with, it can become too low. Or if someone's on blood pressure medication, common ones are say calcium channel blockers, beta blockers, diuretics, but particularly the beta blockers and calcium channel blockers are used for blood pressure now. If you then take too much ginger, then you're going to maybe lower and win, especially if you stand up, you feel lightheaded. As we get older, the arteries can't clamp down, people take falls. So it might not be just that the blood pressure lowers causing the problem, but a secondary effect like falls. So watch out for the lowering of those two items. As a side note in the middle, let's talk about dose, because the daily dose is about 6 grams. People on the lower side would say 4 grams, high side would be 8 grams. If pregnant, less than 1 gram or not at all. So while we're talking about side effects, someone would say, well, would my dose cause it? That would be the accepted dose. Think 4 grams to be safe. If you're one of these people, you like high dose, more of everything is better, 8 grams would be your top end. What are the other things now to watch for? If someone is pregnant or breastfeeding, likely they should not take it. It has been lightly associated with miscarriage and other problems, so that would be something definitely ask your practitioner or doctor about. The next one is thinning of the blood. Another one, along with lowering blood pressure, as we talked about, and lowering sugar, we think are good things. Thinning the blood a little bit, if you want to think of it that way, is often people say, well, that's great because strokes and heart attacks are often caused by a thrombus or by clotting versus bleeding. However, some people are going to be on blood thinners or generally have thin blood. Adding ginger to that can accentuate it, and people are therefore at risk for bleeds. Let's say someone's having an operation, and in my case, doing facial fillers on people or injecting their platelets or their blood products back in for rejuvenation, it can lead to a little more bruisey situation. Not the end of the world for those type of procedures, but a major surgery and someone would potentially have a problem. And I remember I was treating an Asian patient about 12 years ago, and she said, oh, I came off my ginger. And I said, so? I never heard that before. I hear fish oil and everything else. And she said, oh, doctor, don't you know ginger's one of the worst for thinning the blood? She knew right away. And so I learned from her long ago, and I do ask patients now, if they absolutely don't want to bruise, consider coming off of ginger. It does thin the blood. Lastly, it's been associated with irregular heartbeat. So someone has an arrhythmia or heart rhythm problems or family history of such, of course consult your doctor, but you should be mindful. Ginger may not help that. Are you taking ginger? Do you want me to do a video on my ginger turmeric shot? Tell me how you take it. Do you like these videos? Please click like. If you do, I'll do more of them. I put a complete playlist up here on skincare tips that might help you keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.